What's up, guys? MMA Professor here to do my UFC 101 aftermath video. I watched it at BW3's, and yeah, that's pretty much it. Here we go. Started off with the main card, started off with Josh Neer, Kurt Pellegrino. Went kind of like I saw it going. Pellegrino won the first round, I think. He had that huge takedown. A lot of people scored it near. He did have the better striking. I mean, Pellegrino had that huge slam, took him down, and worked round and pound most of the round. So, I mean, that the first round could have gone either way. The second and the third, pretty much the same. Pellegrino shooting on him or getting a takedown from pretty much wherever. He obviously has had the better wrestling. It's something Neer needs to work on. Pellegrino passed a couple times. He had mount, I think, once or twice. Neer, I mean, he tried for a triangle. He tried for an arm, almost had an arm bar. Pellegrino slammed his way out of it. Pellegrino wins 30-27, 29-28 decision, pretty clear cut. Neer looked pretty pissed after the fight, but it was... You know, that's pretty much what I thought Pellegrino would do, just stay out of subs, and that's obviously what he worked on. That was most likely his game plan. Almeida against Kendall Grove, pretty much the same thing. Almeida landed a couple good overhand rights, pushed him against the cage, you know, got a lot of takedowns. Almeida's wrestling is really good, obviously. Either that or, you know, Grove really needs to work on his... the only thing that surprised me in this fight was that Grove almost caught him in an armbar in the second. I can't believe he almost had it. Almeida, being the level of black belt that he is, calmly, you know, stepped over, passed, and he was out of it. But, it's an okay performance for Almeida. I thought he would get the sub, but, I mean... He worked it a lot differently than I thought he would, by getting the takedowns, working from the top, ground and pound. And Almeida's dropping to 170, so this fight really doesn't mean too much in that realm. Bad loss for Kendall Grove, obviously. Amir Sadala, Johnny Hendricks. Another reason to hate Dan Mergliata, I guess. They come out trading leather. Amir Sadala lands some leg kicks. Hendricks... grabs Sadala in a half clinch, kind of throwing uppercuts. Lands 2, 3, 4 of them. Sadala drops, and Hendricks goes to work some ground and pound. Amir on all fours. Hendricks lands 2 punches. Okay, Chase? 2. He landed 2, even though I disagree. He landed 1 or 2. The amount of punches he landed is irrelevant. I know he landed 1 for sure to the back of the head. Maybe caught him with another one. 3 or 4 that missed, and Mergliata steps in and stops it. Sadala moving his left leg up to put his foot and down on the ground and stand back up, and Mergliata stops the fight. Horrible stoppage. Absolutely horrendous. Hendricks... They're probably going to run this fight back again, I would say. Hendricks looked pretty good. I mean, I guess for what we saw of him, his hands looked pretty good. I didn't think he was going to be able to strike that well with Sadala, but yeah. Shane Nelson, Aaron Riley. Yeah, they showed this, and, you know, I pretty much saw it going that way. Riley pushing the pace. Landing pretty good combinations, trying for a left high kick over and over, pushing him against the fence, throwing some uppercuts. Was definitely winning all the striking. Thought he should throw a little more right hooks, but I'm not in the cage with him. I'm not his trainer, so I don't know what the game plan for. Because Nelson seemed to be dropping his left hand a lot, but as a southpaw, I probably would have thrown a right hook, but clearly not in the UFC. Riley wins 30-27. I thought he would be a little more cautious considering the early stoppage the last time, but, you know, Shane Nelson really needs to fight at 145. Joe Rogan's wrong a lot, but, for how much, you know, body fat Shane Nelson has, I think he would suit him better to drop to 145. Anderson Silva, Forrest Griffin. Holy fuck. Holy fuck. You know, Forrest comes out looking to strike with him. I thought Forrest Griffin's game plan would be to push him against the fence, work from the clinch, take him down. His game plan was apparently to strike him with him the whole time, which was a horrible idea. And, you know, Silva, obviously pissed off, because people say he doesn't engage. He was like, come on, the whole time, dancing around, dropping his hands, had no respect for Forrest Griffin at all. This was ridiculous. Forrest Griffin, this was a result, and listen closely, because I'm only going to say this one time, and then the rest of you people that think this was Forrest Griffin throwing the fight, you can go to hell. He got rocked 3-4 times. The last time he dropped, Forrest was winging an overhand right, lunging forward, and yes, Silva threw a short right hand and clipped him, and Forrest was out. We saw the same thing with Gabriel Gonzaga against Shane Carwin. Caught him with a short right, dropped him, he was out. It happens. He was coming forward, that's it. Nobody better, because I got, some people told me that this fight was fixed, and I don't even want to hear it right now. Do not want to hear it. Anderson Silva had dropped in the pound-for-pound rankings, in my opinion, before that. This fight, they have no competition for him, which is ludicrous in the UFC, that nobody at 185 and 205 have any competition. Honestly, if Anderson Silva is willing to fight Machida, have him fight for the belt. Yeah, I know it's going to matter what happens between Shogun Hua and Machida in the next fight, but have Anderson fight him for the title and have him be the second guy in MMA history to hold two belts in two divisions. Because the dude is sick. I gave Dana White a lot of shit for saying he's the pound-for-pound best fighter. He's one or two, for sure, after this performance. BJ Penn, Kenny Florian. Wow. Kenny Florian, you are not George St. Pierre. Please don't try the same game plan as George St. Pierre. I know what your game plan was. I know. Push him against the fence, try to go for takedowns, wear him out. And for Joe Rogan, that's for you. BJ Penn was not tired the entire time. That's how the dude breathes, okay? He's not tired. Oh, he's got his mouth open. Fuck you, Joe Rogan. I like you, Joe Rogan, but fuck you. He was not tired the entire time. Every round was for Penn. Florian's wrestling is not good. Fourth round, BJ takes him down. Works from half guard. Honestly, BJ made him look... He made Kenny Florian look like a white belt in this. Kenny Florian, legit BJJ black belt, made him look terrible. Has mount, works towards his back, gets back. Some heel kicks to the liver, and sinks it in. BJ Penn, Diego Sanchez... Good luck, man, because I don't know what you're going to do against BJ Penn. Like I said before, I think he's the best in the world at 155, and I don't know what you're going to do. Overall, pretty solid. The main events delivered, which is what I was looking forward for mostly. Not really going to give a rating so much, not so much on the ratings, but it was good. And we have WEC tomorrow. It should be a great weekend. Yep, that's it. MMA Professor, I'm out. Actually,
this is my doggy, Circuit. She's making her debut. What's up, doggy? You didn't watch UFC, but would you like it? You would like UFC, right? Yeah, you would. Okay. Well, I'm going to give you some food after this, okay? Give me five. Yeah. All right. Later, guys.